This video is a continuation of the Healthy Makeup Tips series. Tips numbers 61 to 70. Before watching this video, please subscribe to channel and hit the bell icon to be notified whenever we publish new videos. Tip number 61. Wearing makeup near your eyes. When you wear makeup just below your eyes, you need to be gentle with it. This is because the skin under your eye area is very sensitive. Thus, if you apply too much pressure on it, it can appear wrinkled or saggy. Just apply a little amount of makeup on it though if you want to, as long as you are conscious on how you are doing it. Tip number 62. Wearing mascara and eyeliner on summer months. If you want to wear mascara during summer, you should consider the fact that the heat can easily melt down your makeup. With that, it is best if you choose a waterproof mascara and eyeliner for your summertime look, so that you won't have to deal with smudges on the skin near your eyes. Tip number 63. The best way to start in applying eye makeup. The best way to apply eye makeup is to start with a clean skin. What you can do about it is to apply cold compress on your eyes for about 10 minutes. Doing this can actually reduce the puffiness of your eyes. After that, apply a light moisturizer so that the skin around your eyes won't get dried up because of the makeup. Tip number 64. Styling your eyebrows. Some people tend to forget that one of the most important features of a person's face is her eyebrows. Therefore, you should assess it properly, so that you can apply the kind of style that would suit you best. One of the tools to style your brows is called the clipped angle brush. Before using it though, determine the style that you want first, so that you can easily proceed. Tip number 65. The eyeshadow compact. Before making use of your eyeshadow compact, make sure that you have already applied the foundation or concealer to hide imperfections. If your eyeshadow compact offers you 3 or 4 different shades, keep in mind that they are made that way, since you can actually use them together. Practice blending them though, before you attend parties so that you are assured that you are doing it right. Tip number 66. Applying the mascara. Using mascara can accentuate your eyelashes, especially if you are doing it the right way. To ensure that it is the case, when you apply mascara, you should slightly tilt your chin towards the top and lift your eyebrows. By following this position, you would be able to apply mascara without smearing. Tip number 67. Moisturizing your lips. Unless your lipstick is made to provide the needed moisture of your lips, you should make use of a lip balm prior to applying color on them. This practice can actually prevent chapped lips. Having chapped lips is not a pleasant experience, since it can become painful, especially if you are not able to take care of it immediately. Tip number 68. Applying makeup while having pimples. If you have pimples and you want to apply makeup, it is actually fine. However, it is best if you go with gentler types of makeup items. This way, you won't be irritating your skin further. Aside from that, you should refrain from picking your pimples while using makeup, since it can worsen the situation. Tip number 69. Caring for your skin. If you are the type of person who usually wears makeup almost every day, then you should take care of your skin properly. One of the things you can do is to get a facial once a month. By doing this, your skin would be revitalized and purified. When that is achieved, it would become more radiant and won't get easily irritated with certain makeup items. Tip number 70. Your daily makeup. Wear a daily makeup that is simple and light, so that you won't put too much chemicals on your skin. Keep in mind that most makeup products are loaded with synthetic substances, which can harm your skin. Thus, it is best to stay on the safe side, and just use heavy makeup when you are attending a party or going out with your friends. Thanks for watching. Remember to subscribe to channel and check out other videos for the continuation of the tips.